What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. I hope you're having an amazing day. Today's video, we're going to be taking a look at more features that would be introduced into the MIUI. Now, you know, here we do not know when these would be coming to the MIUI China stable or the global stable. Like, global stable would be like 3 to 4 months later if it ever comes to the China stable. So again, here we don't know whether these features would be included into the MIUI 11.1, 11.3 or directly to be 12, because that's coming soon. Well, by soon, I mean June 2020. So until then, we would be just taking a look at these features. Now, in this video, the main focus would be the launcher. Yep, if you saw over there, the animation was very fluid. I mean, it's not a huge change, but the apps no longer zoom in and out from the launch position. It's much more like iOS, and the popping in and out of the apps is just amazing in this. So again, over here, as this is a China base, as you can see, the latest Xiaomi EU build 20.1.16, which is like almost 1 to 2 days old. And as you can see, pretty much normal stuff. If you just take overall looks, this is your app world. Currently, it's some festival in China. That's why it just looks that way. But this is a leaked MIUI launcher 4.16. It's not yet available officially onto the internet on most of the APK sites. So again, links in the description for everything. But if you just take a look at the animations, just look at that, how butter smooth this is. Like, you have to watch this video in 1080p 60fps to just get that sync in. I don't know why the security app just lags. It's just each and every single time on this launcher, the security app will get a bit of a hiccup. But all the rest of the apps just zoom in and out very smoothly. As you can see, it's butter smooth. And then taking a look at recent apps panel, now everything just swipes from the left rather than being from the bottom. Well, I didn't hit the bottom one, but even this looks much more immersive, I guess. As most of the newer phones from Xiaomi, which would be the Mi 10 Pro, which is coming soon, AMOLED 90Hz, this would be amazing. Again, the Redmi K30 Pro, which is a bit more cheaper phone, like almost 16,000 Indian rupees, has a LCD 120Hz panel, and this would be just fabulous on it. But as you can see, still the same animation, but popping from the left gives me a hint that would be something different onto the MIUI 12. As you can see, it just comes from the left completely. But until then, we have to just check. As you can see, very butter smooth. There is no pop in and out or just stutters anywhere. And that's it for the animations. Yep, there's just nothing to it. Like, the functionality is just the same. Even if you go to the settings, home screen, everything is just the same. Like a normal China launcher. But then going back, if you go to additional settings, full screen display, now you have the complete option of Android 10 gestural system. Yep, as this is an Android 10 base, you have swipe up from the corner for Google Assistant. Well, this is a EU feature and it was actually working fine until I installed this China leaked launcher, but that does actually work. And then you have the option for hide full screen indicator, which is just this pill thing. So this is an Android 10 gesture bar. This is completely the thing that you get in Android 10. So Xiaomi has completely adapted that thing. And then now you can just switch between apps, I guess, just like that, or it just completely messes up just like the original Android 10. But as you can see, very smooth. But yeah, that's it for the gestural features. Again, as you can see, it shows the bar right over there, which is much more bigger and kind of suits for the phones like the Mi 9 and the Mi 8, but still not present and not fully implemented. Again, if you want that, you can use some padding features onto the Android's code, but I will just have that hidden. This looks much more cleaner. As you can see, it even hides into the preview right there, which is very nice attention to detail. And then again, pretty much nothing changed over here. All the features still just look and feel the same as I reviewed a week earlier. If you just don't follow me, just follow me. I review these small little features each and every single week, or anything that Xiaomi has bigger in that 3 feature update periods. And then how to get these animations. So again, over here, the requirements over here are Android 10 base. Yep, I still don't know whether it works on the Android Pie or not. Let me know in the comment section below if you try. Then a latest China beta build. It doesn't matter whether you're using Mi Room, Mi Mix, then again Xiaomi EU builds, or just plain China beta. It has to be 20.1.16 or above. It doesn't work on 20.1.9. So again, over here I have my Redmi Note 5 Pro running Android version 10, MIUI 11. Again, a bit older base, like a week old, and this feature just doesn't work on it. As you can see, Android 10. Again, if you want more info on this, just follow me on Instagram. I would be updating you guys on the progress of this build. Video would be soon. Just Bluetooth and some things remaining, like the MTP. But coming back to the phone, you have to be rooted and to up installed. Now, again, you can use any kind of app that you like Lucky Patcher and anything, which replaces the system apps or just updates it. But I just don't recommend it on the Android 10. It might cause some more issues. So directly going to the tour, I would be showing you only one method. There you go. I'm using a LR Team 12, which is like one of the most advanced 12s for the K20 Pro. And then you have to just go to mount system, come back home, go to advanced, file manager. Now all the settings would be same from across all 12s onto the Xiaomi phones that you have. So you have to just go by the names, not by the UI. So going down to SD card where you have downloaded the launcher. There you go. I have already renamed the 4.16 alpha launcher to just MI home. So once you copy it over here, copy file, it would be automatically replacing the one that you have into the system. So directly go into the system root, system. Now if you have a non-system root phone, unlike the Redmi K20 Pro, which is a system root phone, so it takes ABGSIs, there's a system inside the system root. For Redmi Note 5 Pro phones, it would be just system. Once that is done, you have to just go to Priv app, scroll down till you find MIUI home and just paste it right over here. Just go back, go to the system folder where you pasted the APK, system, Priv app, MIUI home, and then click the APK and mount it for readable and writable, which would be just type in 0644, just like that. Hit enter, swipe to confirm, and reboot the system. Once the phone has been completely rebooted, if you find any kind of force closes like social APK has been completely crashed or the launcher just misbehaving, you can directly go into the settings app from the quick settings panel, cause that is completely accessible. Just like that, it doesn't have any issues on my K20 Pro as I'm using the latest build. Just go to the system and clear data for the system launcher or the MIUI home. And yeah guys, that's pretty much it for the latest MIUI 11 leaks. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you found this helpful, please drop a like and subscribe down there for more content like this. And see you guys in the next one. Peace.